Hello everyone. So in the last video we have seen how we can manually convert a value from one range to another range, okay? Or how we can manually manually map a value of a range to another range, okay? So I said you how we can subtract these upper and lower limits of the initial range and how these how that should be divided, how that should divide that our input value, I mean the value of that range, and then how we are supposed to multiply it by the new range, or new range. That means new range maximum value minus minimum value, and how we can get this value. And also we saw that when we are dividing a value, we have to make it as a float variable, not an integer and all. Okay, so now. Now actually you don't have to go through all this pain, guys, okay? So Arduino is giving you an option to do this in a simple and very efficient manner, okay? Here comes our map function, okay guys? So there is something called map function that will do this work for you, and things will be very very cool, okay? So let's see how we can use it, okay? So what we normally do is, okay, let's say we don't have to do these all things, okay? So the map function, what does it do is, it take an input value first. That means the value that it is supposed to be converted, okay? Here it is x, okay? So you have to pass the x first. Sorry guys. Then you have to give a comma. So then you have to give the from low value, okay? So that means, I will tell what it is, okay? Then the from low means, the initial current range value, but the lowest value, minimum value, okay? I will tell it, okay? Don't worry. And then from high value, that means the current existing range, okay? The current range but the highest value, okay? Then I will put another comma, and the to low value, that means the new range that you are going to have the value on, the initial value of the range, that means lowest value of the range, and then the maximum value of the range, the new range, okay? If you pass all these things, this will return you, this method will return you the converted mapped new value, okay? So let's say y, okay? That means an integer value, right? Another integer value, okay? So, okay, that's fine. So, you don't know what these things and all this business is. Okay, anyway, we'll take the same example here. Okay, so, let's say our value is x. Excuse me, guys. Okay. Let's say our value is x, that is 70. And initially, the values, let's say the value is coming from a range. Okay, my initial range is 0 to 100, right? What is this? My initial range is 0 to 100. And I want to convert this initial range value, what are the input values coming from this range, I want to convert to 0 to 10, isn't it? Okay? So initial range and the new range, okay? So from this range to this range, I have to convert any value that is coming, okay? So this from means this from value, right? From range, okay? So from which value I have to start? This value, right? From which range I have to start? From this range. So that is what the from means, okay? And to which range I have to bring? To this range, 0 to 10. So that is what this to means, to the destination, okay? So this is the source, initial place, and this is the destination, okay? I hope you understood, guys, okay? So from which range I have to convert the value, that is what the from low. Low means what? The lowest value. So this, in the from range, what is the lowest value? It is 0. Okay guys? So here I should say it is, I will copy it and I will retype it so that it will be nice. Okay, so the from low value will be, let me have space, 0. That means in another word, the minimum value of the initial range. That's not from low value, 0. So then the from high value, obviously the from range From which range? This range. From 0 to 100. What is highest value? 100. Okay. So 100. Oh, not there. I'm sorry. Here. Okay. So when you type this, Arduino will understand, okay, 0 to 100 is the initial range. That's all. So Arduino will realize this. Okay. Okay. That's what he means. Okay. That's fine. Then the too low, too high. That's all right. So from this range, to which range we are going? 0 to 10. So this is the two values, okay? To which range I'm going? So too low. So to which range? To this range. Low means minimum value. So what is the minimum value for this new range? Two range, 0. I mean the new range that I want the value to be in. Okay, 0. And then too high. So the two range, what is the two range? Two means this range, because from this range to this range we are going. So too high means in this range, that means two range, what is the high value? 10. You understand, guys? So if you write the code like this, the program will automatically understand, okay, he wants an input value x to be mapped from initial range of 0 to 100 to the range of 0 to 10. Okay, so this is the limits of the boundaries or of the initial range, and this is the boundaries of the new range, simply talking. Okay, so we first pass this whatever the value to be converted mapped, and we pass the minimum and maximum value of the initial range. Okay, I mean the from range, a current range, and we will pass the minimum and maximum value of the needed range, which range to which range you want to map. That minimum and maximum value we will pass next to that. So that's all, very simple. Okay guys, it's x 0 100 0 10. Then Arduino will understand. Arduino will do the same equation scenario, this scenario somehow, and it will return the value with no pain. Okay guys. Okay, so I will I will comment it so that you can always refer this. Okay, and I will remove this because I don't want this to happen, and I will take this value. So this map function will return us an integer, an integer, and we will pass this integer as y, because y is our newly mapped value, right? So I want the x to be mapped from 0 to 100 to 0 to 10. Okay, so x to be mapped from 0 to 100 to 0 to 10. That's all. And the map function will return an integer value, and the integer value I'm assigning to y, right? So y is the returned value, right? Newly mapped value. So I will say y is equal to map. Okay, that's fine, right? That's something, that's a very simple thing, right? So since map function is returning an integer value, you are holding it in integer y, so that you will store the newly mapped value in the variable name y. Okay guys. Okay, so I will keep this last line comments, and let's see what happens. Okay guys, so this looks cool. Okay, so in the upcoming video, I hope we can see, I think in the current video we can see a quick demonstration, I hope. So I will copy this, I will simply verify this. So this is 70, so I'm expecting 7 to be the y value. Okay, so I think it's better to do this demonstration in the upcoming video. So done compiling is fine, that means my code is error free. So in the upcoming video, next video, we will do a demonstration. Meanwhile, what you can do is you can upload the code to your Arduino and open your serial monitor and see whether you are getting 7 as the y value, because 70 is the x value, right? So 70 from 0 to 100 should be 7 from 0 to 10. Yes, right guys. Okay guys, so I will catch you up in the next video, guys. Follow me up in the next video.